There's a lady who's sure all it glitters is gold, and she's buying a stairway to heaven. When she gets there, she knows if the stores are all closed, with a word she can get what she came for. She's buying a stairway here. There's a sign on the wall, but she wants to be sure, 'cause you know sometimes words have two meanings. In a tree by the brook, there's a songbird who sings. Sometimes all of our thoughts we'll be right back.
Let's pray. Father in heaven, we praise your name. We just thank you for all your goodness and your blessings, Father. We just pray that you'll just bless this family. We pray for strength for them in this time. Father, we know that the main thing we need to do in this time is look to you for hope, because you have given us hope. And we just thank you so much for it, Father. Just fill their hearts with this hope, Father, and strengthen their lives, we pray. Just bless them now. In Jesus' name, amen. God does love you, and he has worked on making a way for all of us to be together one day in his kingdom. And all we have to do is be a part of that, you know, just accept Jesus Christ as our Savior. and we can be together again. That was the plan. We know we just came through Christmas time, and we celebrate the birth of Jesus. He was born to be the Savior of the world, sent from God. So the only way into the kingdom is through Jesus. And so we need to remember that, you know. Just think about Woody and his life. You know, he had a great love for Harley Davidsons. And we know he named his first two children, you know, Harley and Davidson. But, you know, it's an amazing thing that he wanted to always get him a motorcycle, a Harley Davidson. And, you know, just I hear just a couple weeks ago, he did that. He was able to do that, you know. Just amazing how the Lord blesses. You know, a lot of times we get in grief and we fail to look at the signs and to look at God's plan. And, you know, I hope that's the first thing we look at and want to see is God's plan. You know, Willard was sharing with me that last week early, he just knew that something was going to happen to Woody, and he told Peggy. You know, we think about, he just went out the other day and drove a sign in his front yard. You know, thank you, Jesus. I know when I was at Stones Creek, he came to church some there then, and Peggy was telling me that he was baptized when he was about 15 years old. So, you know, I think that feel like the Woody knew something was going on, just like his dad knew something was going to go on. The Lord has shared this with them, you know, and the thing about it is we need to realize what he's trying to do. Yeah, it's a tough time, but, you know, what about if he had died not even thinking about the Lord or turning away from the Lord, denying the Lord or something like that? But, you know, he didn't do that. He was driving a sign in his yard, says, thank you, Lord. So, you know, through this time, we see that the Lord was working. And I know it's still a hard time, a tough time for family and friends, you know, to lose a loved one. But just think about, we do need to honor the Lord because he was drawing him close to him in those last days. So, you know, just think about that as we think about his life that he lived and how good he was. I know I talked to him many times and I always enjoyed talking with him. He's always a good person, wanted to help somebody, wanted to do something. You know, he was just a good person. So, you know, surely, I'm sure that we can look at anybody's life. We say, well, you know, he did a couple bad things. Well, he probably did, but like every one of us have had something in our lives too. But the Lord forgives us for all those things, that we can be in his kingdom, because none of us are worthy on our own anyway. So, you know, we just want to honor him. Just think about, as it says in 1 Corinthians 15th chapter, if in this life only we have hope, we are of all men most miserable. If the only thing that we have to look forward to is living in this world, in this life, with all the sickness and pain and heartache and troubles that we go through, you know, it's not a whole lot to look forward to. And I know I've talked to a lot of people that's years ago when I was a young man, and they say, you know, it's a lot harder when you get older. And I said, well, it can't be that bad until I got older. And then, you know, the more I realized, well, it is a big difference. Our bodies do fail us. There's a lot goes on. So, you know, just we think about these things that go on in our world. But I want you to remember again, and just like the scripture said here, you know, that but now is Christ risen from the dead and become the first fruits of them that slept. You know, that's just what it is. That's the reason he was born. What he was born for is to be the first. He did die, and the third day he resurrected. He appeared to his disciples in the upper room, them being in there, the doors being shut after his resurrection. He talked with them. He walked with them and talked with them for 40 days after his resurrection, until in Acts, the first chapter, tells about him ascending as they stood around and talk with him. You know, he told them to be sure they stayed in Jerusalem until the power of the Holy Spirit came upon them, which was a gift that was going to be given them after he left. And they did. But, you know, that then they saw him ascend up, and there was a lot of people there round about him. His disciples and people had been with him there. They saw this, and they saw him ascend up, and the clouds received him out of their sight. And as they watched him, two men stood by them and said, "Why stand you here gazing up into the heavens? For this same Jesus that was taken up from you into heaven shall so come in like manner as you have seen him go." You know, surely living in this world, we think about Adam and Eve and their sin in the garden and what we have to go through because of that. You know, everybody is going to die that lives in this world unless Jesus comes back first. Every man in his own order. Christ the first fruits, afterwards they that are Christ at his coming. Then cometh the end when he shall have delivered up the kingdom to God, even the Father, when he shall have put down all rule and all authority and power, for he must reign till he hath put all enemies under his feet. And the last enemy that shall be destroyed is death. So we're going to continue to die until our Lord does come back. And then there's going to be no dying anymore. You know, this is the beginning. We have opportunity here to choose if we want to have eternal life or not, to choose if we want to be in his kingdom or not. And, you know, I think Woody chose. And I think, in especially these last couple of days, you know, the Lord was working with him. And he was drawn close to the Lord. And, you know, I'm thankful for that. And I know you are too. So just, you know, think about that as we think about his life. And then we think about his death. And what comes next? You know, there is a next for those who serve the Lord. You know, some men will say, "How are the dead raised up? With what body do they come?" Well, you know, Jesus showed us that example because he appeared in the midst of the disciples being in the upper room, the doors being shut, but he appeared to them there. And, you know, it says, Thou fool, that which thou sowest is not quickened except it die. You know, anything that we sow, the plants and things that we sow, you know, they grow up and we harvest them after a time. They finish their life cycle. And we know what we do. You know, a lot of farmers around here, they take those seed and they plant them in the ground next year. And what happens? A new plant comes up, doesn't it? You know, so that's just the way God has planned for everything. And he also has planned for us. And God gives it a body as it pleases him. And with Jesus as our example, we're going to take upon ourselves just the spiritual body like Jesus has showed us that we would. So is the resurrection of the dead. Is sown in corruption, it is raised in incorruption. Is sown in dishonor, it is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, it is raised in power. Excuse me. It is sown a natural body, it is raised a spiritual body. Howbeit, that was not first which is spiritual, but that which is natural. Afterwards, that which is spiritual, just like Christ showed us. You know, that's the same fashion that we're going to be changed as well. As is the earthy, such are they are also that are earthy. And as is the heavenly, such are they also that are heavenly. And as we have borne the image of the earthy, we shall also bear the image of the heavenly, if we're serving the Lord. So behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, the last trump. The trump shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. Our bodies are going to be changed, resurrected and changed. And this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass that a saying, and we can all say it then for sure, death is swallowed up in victory. Death does not have the victory over those who serve the Lord. The Lord Jesus Christ has victory over death. He showed us that. He has the victory over death. And those who serve him will have the victory over death as well. Then we can say, O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? You don't have the victory over me because I serve the Lord. The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. There's a lot of things we work for in this world that's in vain, but serving the Lord is not one of them. And that's the only true thing and lasting thing that this world offers us is eternal life through Jesus Christ. I know we think about these days, and we think about the sadness and heartache, yes. Like it says in Psalms, weeping may endure for the night, but joy comes in the morning. And that's what we got to look forward to. He's going to have the victory over death as he served our Lord Jesus Christ and called upon the Lord. And that's one thing that we really have opportunity to look forward to is being together in his kingdom again. at the end, and being together with each other again in his kingdom. Let us pray. Father in heaven, we praise your name. We pray that your words sink down to each heart. We pray and strengthen and guide each one that's here, Father, through this time in their lives, we pray. We thank you now. Amen.
You got me in a suit and tie. I had to take a pull so I wouldn't cry. You got a line out the church door saying goodbye. Yeah, I believe them when they say you're in a better place. You had a wild side, but you had amazing grace. I know you're way off up in them clouds, but if you could still hear me right now, I hope you hit those gold streets on two wheels. I hope you imagine in the sky's got a 10-acre field with some mud and some hubs you can lock in. Make some thunder, make them wonder how you got in. Hide your beer, hide your clear from a man upstairs. Crank it loud, hold it down till I get there. And when I do, I hope you got some new stories to tell. Till then, give heaven some hell. I bet you're looking for a crew like